This video shows you how to create stairs using ArchiCAD's Magic Wand. The intuitive Magic Wand tool can now also be used to create stairs. When defining the stairs baseline, in addition to the polygonal input method, it's also possible to use the Magic Wand to create the stairs baseline based on the geometry of an existing element. We can identify four different scenarios. Clicking a single edge, clicking a chain of edges forming an open polygon, clicking a chain of edges forming a closed polygon, and clicking within a single wall element. Let's look at the first scenario. Select the stair tool and use the Magic Wand function by space-clicking a single element edge, for example, a line element. The stair which is generated will consist of a single flight. The stair's baseline will be generated, so it extends all the way to the opposite end of the clicked line, or as close to it as possible. This is achieved by automatically adjusting the going depth of the stair within its allowed minimum and maximum values. ArchiCAD will consider the clicked point of the edge as the starting point, or lowest point of the stair baseline, if the stair's input method field is set to the upward option. If the input method is set to the downward option, ArchiCAD will consider the clicked point of the edge as the end point, or highest point of the stair baseline. The combination of the input method and baseline settings will determine which side of the line the stair will be generated on and whether the space-clicked point will be the top or the bottom of the stair. When you click an edge that's part of a chain of edges, such as the edges of a chain of walls, the stair baseline is again generated to extend as close to the opposite end of the chain of edges as possible. In this case, the stair will contain flights as well as turnings. Each intermediate node of the clicked chain of edges will define a turning in the generated stair. The turning type setting in the stair will determine whether an automatic landing, a winder with equal angles, or a winder with equal goings will be generated at those turnings. When the turning type field is set to the automatic landing option, riser offset values at automatic landings will be automatically calculated as necessary. The combination of the baseline and input method settings affect the general stair geometry the same way as in the previous case. If we use the magic wand on a chain of edges that forms a closed polygon, the stair is generated the same way as before, with the provision that the upward and input method will generate the stair baseline counterclockwise. While the downward input method will generate it clockwise. If the turning type is set to the automatic landing option, and the stair is generated inside the closed polyline, the stair's baseline will go all the way around the closed polygon, so its starting point and end point will both be at the clicked point on the chain of edges. This is achieved by setting the riser offset values of automatic landings to large enough values so the baseline goes all the way around the closed polygon. A special case of closed polylines is the circle. When space-clicking on a circle, the stair is constructed the same way as it is in closed polylines. However, internally, ArchiCAD considers a circle to be composed of a top and bottom half circle. Thus, if the generated stair's baseline crosses either the left or right quadrant point of the circle, a node will be inserted into the baseline at that point, resulting in an automatic landing or a winder at that node. It is also possible to click into the body of a single straight or trapezoid wall using the magic wand. In such a case, the stair baseline will go around the wall. There are two possible combinations of input method and baseline settings for achieving this. The combination of the upward input method and the left baseline setting will generate the stair baseline counterclockwise, with the top flight along the wall edge closest to the clicked point. The combination of the downward input method and the right baseline setting will generate the stair baseline clockwise with the bottom flight along the wall edge closest to the clicked point. The magic wand method works in the 3D viewpoint as well. For example, you can space click any general surface point of a single straight or trapezoid wall. The clicked general surface point will be taken as input, and the stair will be generated based on the same principles as in the floor plan viewpoint, with the difference that the clicked 3D surface point's height value and its position along the wall edge will also be taken into consideration when setting the exact horizontal starting point and vertical position for the stair.